On a warm evening in May, Faisal Shahzad shocked hundreds of people and New York's finest when he attempted to blow up a car bomb in Times Square. Then came perhaps the biggest surprise. This Pakistani-born terrorist had been taking advantage of our immigration system for years and had recently become a naturalized U.S. citizen.
Initially, he was admitted as a foreign student, even though he was lackluster student at best in Pakistan. And then he got a supposed high-tech worker visa. And then he married somebody in the United States, so he finagled a green card, which is to say permanent status. And then once he had his green card, citizenship was pretty much guaranteed.
Citizenship is perhaps the highest gift our country can give a person. But the current system makes it relatively easy to bestow that gift on potential terrorists. Well, at the same time, ordinary folks can have an amazingly difficult time getting it.
You get through to one department and they can't answer your questions, so they give you another number, you get through to another department.
Sheila Roddy came from Scotland to the U.S. for love, but soon had to fight her way out of an abusive marriage. Little did she know the fight that lay ahead to obtain citizenship for herself and daughter Erin. An 8-year paperwork battle prevented Erin from receiving financial aid and going to college. And work permit problems meant Erin had a tough time getting a job.
We had to fill thousands and thousands of forms.
John is a political refugee who still must protect his identity. For John, the heartache of leaving his homeland has been replaced by another pain, becoming a citizen. That privilege cost him and his family thousands of dollars and 10 years of filling out forms.
It's shameful. I mean, the first thing people see of America is when they send this paperwork in. And what they see is this bureaucratic mess.
It's no secret that becoming a U.S. citizen often takes years, mountains of paperwork, and countless fees, to say nothing of potential legal help.
If you talk to legal immigrants, the one thing that they will tell you across the board is that they made at least one administrative error when applying and had to basically start from scratch.
When do you think that a practice?
Experts say our immigration law rivals the tax code in its complexity. That explains why people like Sheila, Erin, and John struggle so much. And it also explains why terrorists may be able to leverage the system to their advantage.
You set up systems to catch things, but the enemy's not stupid. The enemy every day is gaming the system. They're sending people through customs to see what happens. They're having people apply for visa applications to see what happens.
Citizenship, of course, is the brass ring for bad guys. And in fact, Osama bin Laden has said repeatedly that trying to get U.S. citizens in their network is essential because they can come and go without any problems.
Here are just some of the loopholes that terrorists and others take advantage of. Marriage, sham or otherwise. It's a tried and true formula for bad guys ranging from Shahzad to World Trade Center bomber El Sayed Nusayr. That's because the U.S. approves most petitions to bring foreign spouses over, even couples that don't share a common language. Another loophole, diversity visas. They're designed to open doors for people from countries that don't have the opportunity to send a lot of immigrants. But Andrew McCarthy, author of The Grand Jihad, has found they often open doors for terrorists.
We actually invite people into our country through State Department visa programs, special visa programs, from countries that are the source of a lot of the terrorism that we face.
Another surprise, immigration has not implemented biometric exit checks to match those leaving the country with those who've entered.
But if you don't know who's checked out, you don't know who's still here. You don't know who's overstayed visas, and there doesn't seem to be any real urgency about it.
CBN News asked U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services about these loopholes, but the agency refused an on-camera interview. It provided a general statement to our questions, noting that national security is the bedrock of our work. Part of that process is a very thorough series of background security checks, along with detailed personal interviews. For years, the U.S. has prided itself as a nation of immigrants. And each year, more than 1 million immigrants become citizens.
I've been waiting for this moment for a long time, so I finally get it.
But what are the chances that security and streamlining will become part of immigration reform? There is a growing consensus, even among evangelicals, that more must be done to secure our borders. Many observers, however, also believe that reform will do little to streamline the process and that, in fact, it will likely complicate it. That's bad news for Sheila, Aaron, and countless others who hope and wait for that little piece of paper.
We know it's coming soon because we waited a long time. But it's going to be a day of freedom. There's going to be a whole lot of weight just lifted off our shoulders, literally.
Heather Sells, CBN News.